And here's where I'm going off of. You have a checklist with various statements like level 10, pristine or new. All components are pristine and original. No cracks, distortion, nothing. It's brand new. Okay, most, and I'd say 99.9% of your vintage regulators do not meet this criteria. Level 9, as you can see, is excellent condition. Like new, functions fully, no cracks, distortions, dent, dry rot or vertical grist. There might be a faint patina possible, though it's aesthetically pleasing, okay? Components are all original or exact replacements for regulator. Manufacturer's label is clear, unblemished, slight to non-existent abrasion. So you might have a slight scratch or whatever, but it's still good. Fully functional, ready to dive, regardless of vintage double hose. With regards to vintage double hose regulators, a 9 is the most realistic rating one can hope to achieve, really. Now, when we start talking about level 9, we're talking regulators that have vintage parts, either from the pre-1970 and before. And in this case, we have something interesting, okay? And I will show you a what I call a level 9 vintage regulator. But right now, we'll talk about these strange hybrids. Now, this is a Titan 2. And it was originally a single stage regulator, but I was able to sit there and modify it to make it a double hose regulator. And there's lots of posts on the Vintage Double Hose website for that. Fully functional. Is it a vintage double hose? No. It is technically a modern double hose with new old stock. And yes, like the Argonaut Kraken, you can put splitters and you can have, okay, your pressure gauge and you've got your BC hookup. This one's running at about 130, yeah, right about 135. And of course, I took the original single hose second stage and refurbished it, so it still has some of its little vintage bits, but this would be like a level 9 regulator. New old stock, but with all new parts, you know, fully functional, like new. You can't beat it. Breathes really well too. And check function. And the great thing is you can check function on both. And you're good to go. But this would be what I consider a level 9 regulator, as far as in what we call a hybrid, new parts adapted to old stock. Let's look at what I consider a very close to a 9, and that's this, okay, Seba Gorman Mistral. Now it's got a few little scratches and abrasions on it, and it's been totally rebuilt. And it works like a charm. Breathes well, fully functional. It's got new hoses, new everything on it. This is what I consider a level 9, maybe an 8.7, 8.8, because it does have a little scratch here, and it's got a couple little things there for the collector piece. Now, if you ran into a regulator that looked like this and it was non-functional, all original and non-diveable, I would rate that a 9 as far as collectability, but in reality it would be like a 7.5, because remember, 6, when you go down the list, means it's non-functional, so that's going to drop it down. But for if it was just going to be a wall hanger, it'd be great. For instance, we know that this DA Aquamaster's got wonderful patina. It's got a little bit of set on it and all that, but it's non-functional. Now, I hooked it up the tank and it leaks and blows, but generally, if you look at it, this would be ranked about a 6.5 or 7, because it has just a little bit of verdigris. It's got most of its chrome, but you have to go down the left-hand side on the description of what it is and make up your own mind. For instance, if you have non-functionality, which is 6, but everything else is like a 7 or 8, on the left-hand side of the list, just go down. Okay, well, verdigris, okay, it has none. Okay, zero. That's a nine. If it's got patina on the hoses and the hoses are a little bit old but still flexible, maybe an eight, okay? If it's got a couple scratches, it's an eight. So you got nine, eight, so 8.5. And go ahead and throw six in there. Six and 8.5, well, what's the average? Six, okay, that's gonna be 15 and a half. It's gonna be a 7.25 reg just because of non-functional. But for collecting purposes and wall hangers, it would be a nine. Functionality drops it down to a 7 no matter what. Even if everything else is a 9 and it doesn't function as a regulator anymore, it's actually a 7 or thereabouts. So yeah, about a 7.5. Yeah, 7.5, 7.5. So let's get that out of the way right there. So you go down the right, left-hand side of the list in the different categories from 1 to 10, and you look at the parts and pieces. And you look at the amount of verdigris, the amount of dents, amount of scratches, abrasions, you name it, set in the hoses, things like that, functionality. And piece by piece, you're going to find what your reg is up to. And there's an example at the bottom of the list when you're done. So this would be, in my book, an 8.8 or 9 as far as a rebuilt reg. And you're trying to get it as original as possible. Okay, next. Okay, you've seen this reg before. It's the Blue Can 1960 Phantom 50 with everything new, everything functional. The cans have been repainted, got a new ring around it, even got improved rear clips. Would I rate this a 9? No, I would rate it about an 8.8, although it's fully functional. There's a couple little cosmetic blemishes on it, but it's really close to a 9, maybe an 8.9. Breathes well, fully functional, you can dive it today. This would be a very close to 9, 8.8, 8.9, just because it's missing a little bit of chrome on its back there, just a tiny bit, but not much. And of course, I'm being a stickler, got a little blemish here in the label, but other than that, 8.8, 8.9 reg. Here is a 1973 Royal Aquamaster, and it's got new hoses on it. It came just as a very terribly conditioned reg, had a lot of verdigris on it, and it's been rebuilt. I would give this about an 8.9, with the main issue being, not breathes great, main issue being is over here in Saudi Arabia, it's hard to get a good chrome job, and what we've got here is we've got some flaking and all that. So I tried to have the back can redone, and they didn't do a very good job. And it's actually almost very little chrome and more nickel coming through. That said, they did a good job on the yoke and all that, but there was heavy, heavy verdigris on it. Stripped it down and sent it. It cost me like, wow, big whopping $20 to get it done. So unlike most chrome shops in the United States, I guess I'm getting what I'm paying for. But on the whole, because of that chrome job, I would drop that down to about 8.8. Some would say an 8.5. Fully functional, new diaphragm, new parts, new pieces, breathes great, fully balanced. This one's been down to 50 feet. Other than that, okay, so we'll just say for purposes, you know, for the collector, yeah, if you saw this hanging on a wall, you would go, wow, that's a 9. But really, okay, if to the purist, because of that difference in color on the chrome, plus it wasn't a very good plating job. It's good enough for here until I get back to the States and get it chrome proper. New label, like the old. One thing, didn't have the original label. That's fine. It's got a new label. Looks great. There's a couple of places, actually one place that makes the labels here for it, and I'm trying, Alan Clauda makes them, and he's on the Vintage Double Hose website, but he makes all kinds of neat labels. That said, I would rate this about an 8.5 because of that chrome job in the back. It's, hey, fully functional, looks great, it's got new hoses, like I said, but just because of a couple little cosmetic things, it's not going to make a 9. So we'll just say an 8.5 on it. Also, you know, it got little scratches here on the back, but big deal. Other than that, hey, no problem. Thing breathes great here in the Red Sea. Now we're going to move on in. And these are functional regs, mind you. We're going to start heading down in the non-functional zone here. We're going to go into 7. This is about an 8.5 here on the grading scale. It's a used good condition. So it's between 8 and 9 here on the scale, mainly because of that chrome job on the back. Could have been a better job, but had it been a better chrome job, it would be a 9 in my book.
Level 8. A lot of the rigs you've been seeing are between 8 and 9. Remember, 10 is a new regulator. New. Okay, there are very few out there that are going to be qualified as a 10. Even if you re-chrome, even if you do all that stuff, the best you're going to be able to do is 9 on the grading scale. By adding up components, by utilizing their condition, as you read it on the left side of the grading guide, you can come up with a very good average of what your reg's condition is. Here's an example on this slide. And you add up different components and where they land at, and you come up with an average for that reg.
Now, we've been mucking around in the 8s and the 9s, or close to 9s, and of course a 10 would be a brand new double hose regulator. Now let's look at the 7 section here on the double hose regulator condition guide. Okay, used, fair condition, no cracks, distortions, dents, some dry rot on rubber components with light to medium abrasions on metal or plastic parts, usually from long-term storage. Light verdigris on both interior and exterior of cans and yoke assembly. On interior and exterior cans, no verdigris on interior mechanical parts, the body interior, okay, and that's including where your yoke is and all that. Main diaphragm and one-way valves, mouthpiece, and hose stiff or have taken a slight set or set. Patina hoses and various parts, all components present. Manufacturer's label clear and unblemished, still aesthetically pleasing to look at. And of course, I said semi-functional here. Semi-functional means it's a rough breather. You need to adjust it, or you might have to replace a component in it. But technically, I wouldn't want to dive a semi-functional rig. So using that as a guide, let's take a look at this. Okay, this is a like 66. You've seen it before, 66 Aqualung, and it fits most of that criteria. It's got a slight patina. It has just a tiny bit of verdigris. I've already had the cans open on it. It had no verdigris on its body there. It's got a patina on it, on its hoses. Things are still supple. And yeah, this one leaks. It's not really even semi-functional. I guess I should have left that term out. Either functions or it doesn't. That's why I leave function at 6. Semi-functional just means a hard or rough breather. You got some issues that you need to work out. But this one's got the patina and all that good stuff on it. And this is the original rig. It hasn't been totally molested yet. I did open it up, and the interior was just fine. So this is a really good candidate to get up to a level 8 or higher, up to 9, because the chrome is in pretty damn good shape. Just needs some TLC and some maintenance and be good to go. Now, as far as a wall hanger, shoot. You know, this would be a great wall hanger for the collector. We just want something in the scuba shop and all that, because those are the original hoses, and it's in fairly good shape. So yeah, for a wall hanger, I'd give like an 8.5 or 9 as far as wall hanging capability. But for functionality, drops it back down. This puts it in the 7 zone because it's non-functional, and it does have those other little bits that we see on the regulator guide. We've slapped a Dregger PA61. And this is the one with the neat little straight mouthpiece by Dregger. And at first you're like, wow, it's really cool. It looks original and it's got wonderful chrome. I rate that a 9 or 8.8 and all that good stuff. Does it function? Got the air cranked on? Well, let's just listen. Well, that sounds great. Let's turn it off and clear it out, see what happens. Okay, I'm sucking on it. The air is off, but listen. It's got a hole in its second stage diaphragm and non-functional. Wouldn't want to dive it. Looks great. But let's be realistic here. Okay, the original color, even though this is all nice and green and all that, and I put some green hoses to match up with this green Dräger mouthpiece, and it's got the original straps and all that. Wow, wow, it's great. That's a 9, Russ. That's a 9. No, it isn't. Because the original color of the hoses and the mouthpiece was actually a green-blue color. And over time, they turned to a dark green. But if you ever get a hold of one of these, and if I took these hoses off, you'd see a green-blue color. So even though it looks good, remember, non-functional, it's got a hole in its main diaphragm. Those diaphragms are painted, but I'm working on trying to create a diaphragm for the Dräger's, and they're really huge. Original color hoses, good luck in finding that. For a wall hanger, hey, it looks freaking awesome. For a wall hanger, I'd rate it a 9, but remember, it's a 7.5 reg because it's got the tear in its main diaphragm. Hey, if I had a new diaphragm, it's diveable, it'd jump it up to about an 8.5 just because the hoses aren't the original blue-green, they're just a green color to match the green patina of the mouthpiece. Now let's talk about number 6, used medium condition, okay, no cracks, and this rig, doesn't this is a 1961, with its flex hoses still, original, it's got some set in it, you can tell, if you look at it, it's got some good set on it, but it's got all of its original parts, including key, the key is right there, inside, a little bag, I haven't worked on this one yet, but looking at it, you got some verdigris and some abrasion, quite a bit. You've got some missing of chrome on it. I'd say maybe about at most what 5%. Not too bad. You also have a little bit of damage to its label, and you've got of course scratches on the face. The crown sticker is messed up a little bit, but not bad for being a 55-year-old rig. Of course, it's missing. Well, they have the actual clamp in the bag, but it's got the original mouthpiece and the Spiro Technique stretch hoses, which they made only for 1 year. So that pretty much dates this rig. Plus serial number 219302 puts that right in the 1961 zone for when they came out with these kind of hoses. Now, hoses are still supple, but there is some a little bit of dry rot coming about. You can feel it in there. It's a little crispy. And it's a little crispy on the mouthpiece to a degree. Non-functional, of course. Yeah, I'm not even about ready to hook this one up. It does have some verdigris. It does have those abrasions. And when you take a flashlight and run it in there, you'll see that main diaphragm is pretty crispy too. Although I haven't opened it up, I'm looking at seeing some verdigris down inside the actual nozzle too. So yeah, that would definitely be a solid 6 for collector's purposes. Still a pretty cool piece to hang on the wall. For our purposes, for functional diving, no, this one would be very easily brought up, especially nowadays, to a level 8 or 9 without much of a problem. You'd have to get some another flat chrome job done on it. If you wanted to get it up to a perfect 9, get the cans re-chrome. You could even get a new label. Next, on Vintage Double Hose website store, and they have a label section, and there's a link to A&D Adventures inside there, and he makes all kinds of wonderful labels that are exact reproductions, only with better material. He's using stainless steel instead of brass, and he does a wonderful job. He also makes a vintage harnesses for single and double tanks from the early 60s and before. I got another six I want to show you. Okay, here's a 1953 trademark by Cousteau, and if it's got the original Tinnerman clamps on there, although the hoses are still very supple, I'm actually amazed. And you have very supple, this one was actually well taken care of considering it's about, you know, almost 60 years old. You do have some issues. You have some verdigris down there. The label has been deteriorated. You've got deterioration of chrome on around the body, probably about 10 to 15%. Okay, and you, right here you've got some serious verdigris right there, which will tell you that probably got some verdigris on the inside of the can, but you see some verdigris around. That's another good solid six. Definitely non-functional. This regulator can easily be made a 8.5 to 9 without any real problems. You can have a butt ugly reg like this and go ahead and put new parts on it and all that and get it back in the water without doing all the re-chroming. What I'm saying is if for just a wall hanger, this would be great. You know, if a wall hanger book, that would be an 8.5, okay? Maybe an 8 because it's got that verdigris on it, but it would look great in anybody's scuba shop. But remember, I like to rebuild regs, so you could get this one back up and looking really pretty. You could even get a new label done for it and get it pinned in, and it'd be a great reg. It doesn't have any dents. It has just a lot of abrasion scratches and lost chrome loss, and it would be a fairly easy rebuild, and I'll eventually get around to it too. So now I'm going to go ahead and go to a 5.